दिस केस इज 55-year-old फीमेल पेशेंट प्रेजेंटेड विद ड्राई कॉफ फॉर लास्ट 5 months, ब्रेथलेसनेस ऑन एक्सर्शन फॉर 5 months, अलॉन्ग विद लॉस ऑफ वेट एंड लॉस ऑफ एपेटाइट. देयर इज नो हिस्ट्री ऑफ फीवर, स्पूटम, ऑर्थोपनिया और पेडलिडीमा. पास्ट हिस्ट्री ऑफ स्पूटम पॉजिटिव ट्यूबरक्लोसिस इज प्रेजेंट 1 year बैक. एंड चेस्ट रेडियोग्राफी शोज बाइलेटरल हाइलर प्रोमिनेंस. मैंटू इज पॉजिटिव. एसी इज 134. एंड दीज आर द दिस इज द सीटी फाइंडिंग ऑफ द पेशेंट.
माइक गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन. So we have the pulmonology team.
Yeah. Good morning to all. I think probably we are starting the case actually. We are given a short GA actually. So in fact, I have just gone through the using a scope, EBUS scope. I'm just getting into the initial basics actually in terms of doing EBUS. We have this vocal cord being there actually. Vocal cord, yes, we need to see how we're going to negotiate the vocal cord. It's the first time for somebody as a beginner who starts the EBUS scope. Where I think when you see the vocal cord, ideally you are supposed to get into anterior commission and get into this actually. So that the posterior, the usual conventional understanding that when you do bronchoscopy, the posterior aspect is the one which is wider. But in the EBUS scope, which has an angle of more than 45 degrees, probably you need to see into the anterior cords. Yeah, now this way you can see the anterior chunk of a vocal cord, then slowly get in actually. So once you get in actually, probably you're in the main trachea. As you go down, actually, the usual understanding is that go to the right paratracheal. How do you go with the 4R is that first you need to go into 3 o'clock position, localize your azygous vein.
So what you're saying that you are going against the right?
Yes, sir.
Right of the lower trachea.
Yes. Yeah. Right lower end of the trachea I'm going into. First at the 3 o'clock position, you need to localize your azygous vein.
Then so it is 4R.
For anything more than just above the azygous vein is 4R lower paratracheal lymphoma which comes up.
So you think this structure that we are seeing right now is the 4R structure?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So that is good. So can we have a size assessment of the size of the node?
Yes, sir.
It is 4 centimeter. Okay.
It's a big chunk of a lymph node what we see in the 4 paratracheal region. We generate into Dopplers also.
But 4R lymph node should be related to vena cava also.
Yes,
huh?
Sir.
Do you think this is 4R? What is this?
SVC.
Okay, SVC. Okay. So this SVC can we trace it to the trace it both ways? Okay, it is getting into a bigger chamber.
Yeah.
Okay, so this is the right atrium now.
Right.
Okay. So this is the 4R and this is the right atrium and this is the superior vena cava. Am I right?
Yes, sir. 100%.
Okay. So this is good. So this is good. A very good demonstration. I think an excellent demonstration of the 4R station. And we will see whether we can, means later on if there is any need, but this is an excellent, quick, very quick. Means you took only 2 minutes, man.
Yes.
That is.
Thank you.
Can you go into the right bronchus also, please? What is this? So this must be the left atrium.
Yeah, that's right, sir. Left atrium.
The left atrium you can see only from the right bronchus or from the left bronchus also.
Right probably.
Yeah. Okay. So this so we will freeze it. So what you are saying is right now that for the beginners that this is the left atrium.
Yeah.
This is the right atrium or IVC, SVC, and this is the aortic roof. Okay. So the aortic root lies more on the right side. And the aortic descending aorta lies more in the, and this is where you are expecting the fora.
Okay. Yes, sir.
And this is the superior vena cava. Okay. So now, why don't we take an FNAC before you, because we would like you to take the FNAC and tell your tricks of FNA.
Can you pass the needle? Needle.
After you have taken an FNAC, please demonstrate if there are more stations, more lymph nodes right, at sir. Different stations in this case.
Always try to keep your scope in a neutral position when you're getting a needle inside the working channel.
You'll have to go slow because there are many beginners like us. they don't allow me to do EBUS. We want to know your tricks now. We will not get opportunity to.
Yeah, can we get the sheath being, can I see the tip of the sheath actually?
Okay. You want to see the sheath?
Tip of the sheath to safeguard my needle actually so that I don't puncture the.
Okay. Some problem?
This, yeah, then I think probably once you have this sort of a synchronization endobronchial and EBUS image, I want somebody to stabilize the lower end of the. Yeah. Then I need to know the trajectory in which the needle comes into the lymph node. Try to free my needle.
So you are in?
Yes, sir. To clear the distal endobronchial, if there's anything when you have passed with the stretch, I think probably you can use this to dislodge this endobronchial stuff. Then, sorry, remove the stilet. Then, I think with the sectioning, now try to cover from the cortex to the cortex actually. Make sure they're not eating a SVC to draw a mixed venous blood actually. Sometimes invariably we tend to, I think more than 10 to 12 excursions what I generally tend to do from end to cortex. And try to do a fanning method actually where I think the gentle flexion exchange of the scope, we can get into different corners of the lymph nodes so that we can get a maximum chunk of a tissue from all different corners of the lymph node station. Yeah. Now I don't know, I'm sure that there's no blood. So slowly try to get this needle into a sheath, then try to unlock it and just try to remove and block.
So you removed the needle? Okay. Yes. So now in the meantime that we see the sample,
right,
I would like to show something important to the audience. Okay. Now see the needle, how it is behaving. There are three parts of needle you should see. This is part one. I will clear these characters. This is, I will write here character. This is part one. And this one part is reverberating. This is part two, and this is part three. So you will find that the part one is reverberating artifact. The sound waves are entering within the needle, then they are reverberating within the needle, and they are not going beyond the needle. So artifact is going all the way to the edge of the screen. Now part two is gone. Why? Because the sound waves enter at an angle here. And with an angle, they get diffracted and they run within the lumen of the needle. So this part, if you do it in an underwater tank, would be seen here. The third part, the most interesting part I can say, which we don't see in this case generally, but which we have shown is that as soon as you push the needle, it breaks into finger part, five fingers. So the finger part that it is breaking is known as the grating lobe. artifact. So this is in this, the real needle is generally here, and rest are all the artifacts. So this is a very beautiful video. If I run forward, it forward and backward. There's a, as you see, this needle part two and part three is same grating loop. See, you see, at least five needles are there. So you will see this grating loop artifact because this is the part of ultrasound limitation. So this is a very beautiful. I have never seen such beautiful grating loop artifact. And okay, so you please continue with your demonstration. Anything else you want to show? Sample more needed?
One more sample I can use.
Yeah, one more. So anything else in the meantime, you see any other node is there? Why are there four R? Why can't these be 8 and 9 and? So when we are seeing the Supya Vena Cava, this has three tributaries. One of the tributary is the Ajay Ghosh vein, and two tributaries are brachiocephalic and left and right brachiocephalic vein. What you are looking for is whether this Ajay Ghosh vein, just before it comes and merges into Supya Vena Cava, whether. So why don't we trace the Supya Vena Cava from the right trachea and show it, if you can show this. Yeah, here. So could it be the Ajay Ghosh vein here? Yes. If we apply color, yes. Virottam was very right, probably. Yes. When he caught, we will apply color Doppler. So somewhere you are seeing, if we rotate and we will find, yes. So Supya Vena Cava has got only three tributaries. So one is Ajay Ghosh vein and second is left and right brachiocephalic vein. So what you are saying is possibly this is the merging of, this curving is the merging of Ajay Ghosh vein into the Supya Vena Cava. Okay. So is there any other lymph node you want to look for? In the left side, you have looked in the right bronchus. So you got time, you can look in the...
below.
Yeah. Okay. This one. Does it join that this chamber? So this is 4R. No, Viruttam. I would say that this part is more intrapericardial part. Ajay Ghosh vein joins the extrapericardial part. And this is, no, this is not Ajay Ghosh. This is, okay. Now I will tell you what is this. Yes. This is left atrium. And when you rotate it clockwise, this divides into two branches. This is left superior pulmonary vein, and that is the left inferior pulmonary vein. You agree?
Yes, sir. 100%, sir.
So now that the good, please demonstrate that again. Okay. So what you are demonstrating now?
Left atrium.
Okay. So I will write. We will go slow for the audience because you are masters, but the audience has to learn. So left atrium. So what will you do is rotate it clockwise. Okay. Okay. Please. And now what you are saying is that this is left superior pulmonary vein and this is left inferior pulmonary vein. I have written an article on, now there's a question. The Supya Inferior Pulmonary Vein. No. So now I wish to inform the audience an important anatomical aspect. The veins unite after crossing the bronchus. The pulmonary artery divides after crossing the bronchus. So the bronchus defines the boundary. So then this should be 7. This should be 7. So this is, but first you please see it again and decide whether I am right or not. This lymph node is 7 and this is 4. So this is 4 and this is 7 lymph node. See, the way the left atrium is 3 centimeter in transverse diameter. The subcerebral space is 5 centimeter. So in this transverse diameter, veins will unite after crossing the bronchus. So this lymph node is 7 up to this place. And when you rotate it more, you will find probably the end of the right bronchus. And then you will go into 10R. Right. So this is not. You take Nitin.
Yes.
So anything else you want to show? You have shown the right bronchus. So this is right inferior pulmonary vein. You have shown right inferior pulmonary vein, right superior pulmonary vein. You have shown the left atrium. And then you have shown the superior vena cava. So anything you want to show from the left bronchus, please go into the left bronchus if you can. So the sample has been taken second time?
This is one of the Mickey Mouse sign what we generated to see, sir.
Okay, okay, that's brave. Sorry. Mickey Mouse sign, what did you say?
Aorta and pulmonary artery, in between that is a left foreal fascia actually. The proximal aorta.
And this one?
Pulmonary artery.
Left or right?
Left.
Left one. And this is?
Station? 4L. 4L.
4L, okay. And this is ligamentum artery. There are only two ligaments which we can see. One is ligamentum arteriosum and the second ligament people is pulmonary ligament. But that is better seen on
US.
Okay. Because pulmonary ligament lies below. Okay. So, but so you came back, I think.
No, I'm there at the left main only, sir. Left main.
Okay. You are in the left bronchus. Now.
Left main bronchus, actually. This is 7 section.
So this is 7. So we are finding different structures from here. Can we try and find the vascular structures because. Oh, this is the mitral wall. Are we seeing the mitral wall? We have to rotate and find if we can find. This is the interatrial septum.
Yeah.
Okay. And then if you rotate, we'll find the mitral wall probably somewhere here. Wait a minute. Can we do something? Can we inject some agitated saline? Okay. And identify which vessel it is into the superior vena cava. We'll push once more. We come back because that is what Dr. Dikshita has shown today. So, but this is the left bronchus structures we have shown. Okay. More rotate to the left. More. Then clockwise. We want to take one more sample before.
Yeah, I think we'll go for one more sample, please.
So we have shown the excellent structures. And one before we go on to take the sample, one last question. Yeah, can we put in some bubble? Yeah, these bubbles are in the. Yeah, these are the bubbles of the going into the superior vena cava.
Needle pass.
So this is we have agitated saline injected.
Yes, just now injected, actually, sir.
Yeah, so this is agitated saline. So you confirm that this is superior vena cava because the air bubbles are moving within the superior vena cava. So please.
somebody hold it?
So, so उन्हें डॉक्टर अभी को ले जा, वो आप ही करते हैं।
Somebody hold it. Yeah. We should be very mindful about the cartilage thing also. Sometimes when you put a lot of pressure, actually, the needle can tend to bend also. Whatever. Careful, take the zero. Take the middle.
Done?
Mm-hmm. 1 second, sir.
Okay. So you are taking out the secretions.
Needle is broken.
No?
Needle is broken.
Something wrong? You didn't? You can take the longest of the left hand?
Yeah.
Okay. You can remove the bronchoscope and take it up with the bronchoscope.